రమతా గారు మిస్టర్ జయేష్ రంజన్ విసి అండ్ ఎండి ఏపీఐఎస్సి హూ హ్యాస్ షేర్డ్ విజ్ వెరీ వెరీ వాల్యుబుల్ ప్రాక్టికల్ ఎక్స్పీరియన్స్ విత్ ఆల్ ఆఫ్ యూ ఇన్ ఎ నట్ షెల్ జస్ట్ నౌ సంజయ్ కుమార్ ఆఫ్కోర్స్ హీ హాజ్ నాట్ కమ్ అవర్ ఎంఎస్ బాపయ్య చౌదరి గారు హీ హాజ్ రియల్లీ మేడ్ ఆల్ ద రెలవెంట్ సెక్షన్స్ ఆఫ్ ది Act, which is applicable to pollution control measures, and Mr. Anil Reddy, Venkat Jasti Garu, distinguished delegates and participants who have come here to deliberate on the environmental laws and regulations and the contemporary issues in the role of industry today. I definitely hope and wish that this seminar will be a grand success, and the way the enthusiasm shown by the speakers and also the way they have projected the issues, core issues, which are really relevant to the context of present day administration of pollution management and environment management. Really, that will become a grand success. Seminar will become grand success, and they will bring out a very, very good and practicable solutions, suggestions to resolve the issues related to pollution, especially visible aspects, as our Mr. J.S. Ranjan has already spoke. Speakers have elaborately covered all the aspects. I need not take much of the pains nor the time. All of you are aware there are several causes. What will not cause the pollution? There are so many causes. Of course, mainly we say major industries. Industries are the main polluting agencies. But apart from that, other sectors like transport sector, even our domestic sector, home management, home waste, lot of solid waste. Similarly, even agriculture is causing lot of pollution, aquaculture causing lot of pollution, and all the water bodies are getting contaminated for various reasons. Ultimately, whatever it may be, the result is air pollution, land pollution, and water pollution. You all are aware, recently, most of the deaths in hospitals we are observing, especially for the last 1 year, ultimately because of pulmonary problems, respiratory problems, especially after particular age, after crossing 70 years, senior citizens are succumbing to the air pollution because of several carbon monoxide or carbon dioxide, whatever will be constant exposure to the polluted air. Because of that, they are suffering from pulmonary problems, and suddenly that is becoming irrecoverable. So lot of deaths recently noted. Last rainy season, especially winter season, something went wrong in the atmosphere, and most of the cases for days together, some particles are suspended in the air, and especially people who are having this asthma problem, they suffered a lot this last winter season. So these are the resultant effects of our pollution, and clubbed to that, transport sector is very, very, because number of vehicles are increasing. Whatever the measures we are taking, that is not, they are not adequate, sufficient to control this type of pollution. Similarly, soil and land is also getting polluted. Soil quality is affected. Lot of effluents released into the atmosphere, soil. They are mixing with the soil and they are affecting the soil quality and the agriculture crops, whatever crops, vegetables and all, when they are grown in the soil, what particular type of soil, the residue is getting deposited in the roots and leaves and stems of the vegetables or other plants, and that is also causing lot of problem, especially fodder for the cattle. This fodder, because of heavy doses of fertilizers or pesticides or other effluents released into the atmosphere, because of this they are getting highly toxic and causing several problems. What happens once, if that animal milk is taken, milk produced by that animals is taken, these residues of the toxic materials are getting into the human body, and you know the result of that, what happens when it gets deposited, even in small fractions it is causing cancer and other disastrous diseases for the mankind. Similarly, our lakes, water bodies, now you see no pond is fit for using proper for human consumption. You take it away, there is no this thing. As our friend said, this water bottles we never imagined 30 years back. Today we are, without that we are not able to survive. In our childhood, in our villages, we were drinking just straight away pond water, lake water. Nothing has happened. That much clean atmosphere was there. Now today, all our water bodies are polluted. It is high time now. We have to endeavor together and evolve strategies. It's very, very big task, Herculean task. It's not possible with one FAPSI or one industrial sector or one industries department or pollution control board or with one department. It's a collective effort. People as well as stakeholders like your organizations and also government agencies, departments should come together with the help of NGOs and other facilitators and ensure that certain strategies are practically evolved, practical way of enforcing the laws. There are good number of laws, lot of stringent sections are there. Even as our friends already said, the High Court and Supreme Court are they are not at all considering any small fraction of this thing also. Anything with regards to the pollution aspect, they are on stringent side only, other side only. They are taking very serious action, giving orders also like that. Because of that seriousness, Supreme Court, because lot of litigation has increased nowadays, so many people are raising their voice and approaching the courts. Of course, this Right to Information Act also has come. Because of that, so many people are approaching the government departments and other departments, and they are obtaining lot of information. And with that information, it has become handy for them to go to the court and put litigation petitions. Because of this litigation, industrials are dragged to the court and government agencies are also dragged to the court, and they are pulling us up like anything, pulling. Here, because the number of cases are increasing, Supreme Court has considered, and now the National Green Tribunal, another baby has been born these days. And National Green Tribunal is earmarked for dealing with the environmental offenses and forest and wildlife related offense cases. There is a bench at Chennai and Delhi. They are dealing these cases nowadays. So therefore, my only suggestion is, it's a very complicated and intricate subject. One cannot, it's not that easy to understand and how to implement the laws, how to enforce the laws, balancing development as well as industrial development one side for the prosperity of the nation and the development, for employment and other reasons, prosperity. And other side, at the same time, the quality of life of the human beings and animals and our environment should not be disturbed. How we will balance it? Sincerity should be there in enforcing whatever conditions are imposed. In all the environmental clearances given, in all the forest clearances given, we are all aware, Ministry of Environment and Forest, the department is giving minimum 20 or 25 conditions, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. If all these conditions are religiously implemented, followed, I don't think there will be pollution from that particular industry. That much sincere effort should be there from the particular individual industry. Of course, subsequently some litigation will be there. All these things we can combat very successfully. So effective coordination is only answer for this. And awareness building, awareness of the laws, sections, provisions, because a day in and day out, Supreme Court is giving new orders that has to be updated, knowledge has to be updated. And I also suggest that wherever some industry establishments cannot totally contribute directly, they can indirectly contribute to the mitigation of the pollution, taking steps for mitigation of the pollution, like contributing some, maybe there as a corporate social responsibility, some fund can be earmarked. These type of legislations are understanding, some arrangement has to be, some mechanism has to be put in place, then only we can overall, government has to take care of this aspect, and some green cess or whatever you call, some fund should be pulled, and from that money, wherever some problem is causing, the concerned authority should immediately take out some fund from that consolidated fund and spend that money immediately to mitigate that pollution, instead of waiting and fighting with the court, or instead of waiting and wasting our time to solve the problem, to redress the grievance of the local community or people. Immediately the attention can be there and the activity can be taken up. So with these few words, now I will close. And my message to FAPSI is, this is a really very good gathering, and very eminent people are there. I know previous occasions also I have attended. I am sure that you will elaborate and deliberate in an excellent manner, and you will bring out some beautiful practical solutions and suggestions so that the pollution aspect can be, to a large extent, can be resolved. I once again thank the authorities for having given me this opportunity. Thank you.